Thought I was supposed to meet you up at the club.
Well, you still are. I just bought myself a new swimming suit tonight.
Oh?
Yes. See? That?
Well, I got off work in 10 minutes.
Follow me out then.
Follow you? Listen, I can change clothes and beat you out there. That's my girl. Her father's Robert I. Miller. Writes all those adventure books. You ought to see her swim.
Hey! Gee, I sure am sorry, sir. I guess I was thinking about having dinner with my girl. She lives up at the club.
I still. tail.
Anybody? Just take it easy and tell me what happened.
I saw a giant.
What?
Well, I did. Honest, I saw a giant.
No, it was right in the middle of the road. Not a half mile from here.
He doesn't believe me.
You didn't really expect anyone to, did you, Miss Miller?
Why not? It's the truth.
Honey, a prehistoric monster is a rather large order to swallow.
Dad, I didn't say he was a monster. He was a giant. Well, you know, a caveman.
Club and all, eh?
Yes.
What my daughter saw, she saw. Now, let's just let it go at that.
Okay. But if you see her giant again, let me know in time to take some pictures.
She will.
Dad, you don't believe me either.
Roxy, of course I believe you. I believe you saw something.
Well, I saw a giant. A prehistoric giant.
How about it, Tom? What'd you see?
Like I told you, Mr. Miller, I wasn't there until afterwards.
Tommy Nelson, I know what I saw.
Sure, Roxy, but I mean giants.
There were giants. The Bible says so.
Yes, it does, in the book of Genesis. Something about in those days, giants walked the earth.
Well, then.
Maybe we can get some flashlights and go out and take a look for ourselves. Huh?
No, this thing can wait until morning. Now, you kids go and take your swim before the pool closes.
In the morning now.
It's a promise.
Dad still doesn't believe me.
Sure he does.
And neither do you.
I swear on my Elvis Presley LP. How big did you say he was?
Oh, bigger than anybody you ever saw.
I bet you were scared, huh?
A little. But I had the funniest feeling he wouldn't hurt me.
Yeah?
In fact, I thought it was kind of cute.
Oh.
Realistic about this. You said yourself that you fainted. Isn't it possible that you dreamed this whole idea?
No, Dad, I didn't. There was a giant.
Now, I don't want to call this story of yours a lot of foolishness, and I haven't so far, have I?
No.
But if there were a giant, if anyone at all
had been
here...
come here.
What'd you find?
I don't know. It sure looks like a footprint, though.
Well, let me see. There's the heel, and there's the toe.
Look at the size of that. It must have been made by...
Say it.
A giant.
What did I tell you? And that's for finding it.
I'll find the big boy himself for it if you feel like that.
He left the road right here. Watch out for snakes.
Ooh!
Better go back to Tom.
No! He's my giant.
Holy cow, he was standing right here watching us. And then he turned and took off her.
Shadow Mountain. Do you suppose that's where he lives?
It's possible. That would account for his never having been seen before.
It's too bad we didn't bring the doom buggy. We'd go after him.
What for?
I'd get some pictures. Maybe even to bring him back. A lot of people aren't going to believe this giant jazz.
No, we're not sending about this, you understand?
Why not? After the way everyone laughed at me.
Your turn will come. I'm going up on Shadow Mountain with a camera.
Are you going to write a book about the giant, Mr. Miller?
That's the idea, Tom.
I'll take you up there. My doom buggy's all ready to go.
No, thanks.
It is. I just gave it the works.
There's no offense, son. But I'd like to take this trip in something a little bit safer. Now, my credit cards are in the desk drawer. You make sure you leave them there.
This thing's supposed to be safer than my dune buggy?
All right, Kruger, let's go. Now, don't you forget, I want you to meet me at the mouth of Deep Canyon tomorrow at 4.
No, no.
Just one of those things. Just a minute, please. Do you know where Deep Canyon is?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure. I've been there lots of times. Why?
Don't worry, Mr. Kruger. I'll take care of it. Yes. Thanks for calling. Goodbye.
What's up?
That was Mr. Kruger from the airport. The helicopter blew a gasket or something. He won't be able to pick Dad up.
At Deep Canyon?
Yes.
No problem. We'll get the dune buggy and we'll whiz right out there.
This is whizzing?
Wait till we get off the highway.
Hang on to your starter belt.
There's no run here.
This is what the buggy was made for.
There you are, Deep Canyon.
I don't see Dad anyplace.
Maybe we're early.
It's past 4:30.
That water.
Well, I don't want it to dry out before Dad gets here. And don't you eat anymore.
Okay.
It's 9:00. What do you suppose happened?
Oh, nothing happened. He's not coming out of butts, you know. You can't expect him to be right on the dot.
I know, but he should have made it before dark.
Don't worry about it. He'll see the campfire and come walking in on us any minute now.
That's what you said 2 hours ago.
Well, he will.
Well, if you believe that, what's the idea of the bedrolls?
Look, I carry all this junk in the buggy anyway, so you might as well get some use out of it.
I'm not sleepy.
So, just lie down, take a rest for a while. I'll keep the fire going.
Hey, what are you doing with that?
I always carry a gun in the desert. There's coyotes around a camp.
Put it away. We're not playing cowboy.
You know there's mountain lions around here, too.
Well, they won't come near a fire, I know that much. And I'm not going to have you take a shot at something that turns out to be dead.
Okay, okay. I'll put it away in one condition, that you crawl in and get some rest.
Okay.
Now, wouldn't you like to know?
Tom?
Yeah?
Do you suppose Dad found the giant? Or the giant found him?
Nah. Giant probably is way up in the mountain. Your dad wasn't going that far.
I guess not.
Well,
Oh, it's my transistor. Something's wrong with it.
No kidding.
Yeah, sometimes a bump starts it off and you gotta hit it again to stop it. Oh, I must have bumped it again.
You must have. Hey. Have you been at this? We were saving for Dad.
What?
The stew.
I didn't touch it.
Well, I sure didn't. And look at...
Listen, if he comes back for that club, we'd want to be anywhere around here. You sure it is?
Well, I borrowed it enough. Look at where it's smashed.
Well, he could have dropped it.
Well, then why didn't he pick it up?
Well, it's broken. It's no good to him.
Oh, well, it's also insured. Let's not kid ourselves.
Let's not jump to conclusions either. Come on, let's try that next ravine. I'll climb up there ways and see if the buggy can get through. No, you better stay here.
No.
There's no use in both of us going. We gotta come back for the buggy anyway.
Well, then we'll come back. I'm not going to sit here doing nothing.
Oh, women. Look, you stay here with the buggy.
Nope.
And drive it up to meet me when I give you the signal. That'll save us both a trip. Come on.
Well, okay.
Okay. The gun. Toss it. Give me a blast in that horn if you see anything.
Don't worry about that.
Mm-hmm.
Roxy. 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 Roxy.
Oh, Dad.
Oh.
Oh, are you hurt?
I think my collarbone's broken.
Here, let me help you.
How did you get here?
Well, we came looking for you, and we were both so worried that we didn't know what to do.
No, no. No, 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 no. She's mine. She's mine.
He understands you.
We've got a beautiful friendship going. Take it easy.
Me scare him?
Smile. Smile. He likes your perfume.
Smell all you want. Go ahead.
What became of the others?
What others?
Keep smiling. You didn't come out here alone, did you?
No. Tom's with me. I mean, he's out there someplace.
Hold still. He's just curious. Hold still.
It's real, see?
It's
looking.
What's he doing?
Looking for lice, I believe. Careful, honey. Take it easy. He won't hurt you.
He hurt you?
No. I did that myself when I fell on the camera.
Dad, I think you better break this up before I scream.
Tell him you're hungry.
I'm not.
Well, think of the alternative.
I'm hungry.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, hungry. What are those?
Those are his relatives.
They're dead.
Yes, apparently for some time.
Eegah.
Come on, Dad. Let's make a run for it.
Yeah, it won't work. The entrance is blocked.
Oh, what are we going to do?
I don't know. But we'll think of something. He's telling his family all about you. He told them about me last night.
Think how lonely he must be.
I know whatever he is, he's a human being. Shake hands with him, Roxy.
Oh, Dad. Oh, please meet you. Doesn't he know they're dead?
I think so. He just can't make himself accept it.
I'm not having any trouble. And how are you feeling today? Oh, that's fine.
That's the word he says most of the time. Eegah.
Oh, Dad, no.
That's all I need now is a good drink of seltzer water. Ooh, I don't see how anybody could drink that horrible stuff. I guess it can't hurt me.
Make it last as long as you can. She won't hurt you if you're doing something.
A prehistoric gentleman, huh? Thank you. Well, here's to you. Ugh. This water doesn't make you strong. You have to be strong to drink in the first place. No, I'm still thirsty. Thank you.
What is it?
Believe it or not, Dad, I'm going to look at this etching. Oh, this is nice. No. This. Let's see what you mean. Dad?
What is it?
Look at this drawing. It's me in my car.
Roxy!
If Eegah makes me drink any more of this sulfur water, I'll die.
We've got to keep him busy.
I know.
And it's not so bad, as a matter of fact. A little bitter. But it seems to have a certain quality that's good for you. I wouldn't be a bit surprised if the sulfur in these walls isn't what's kept these giants alive all these years.
You mean these giants have always been here?
Where have you seen those before?
In that cave in France.
Exactly.
Sure.
Same style, same everything. Definitely prehistoric. Yes, I'd say that he and his tribe have always been here.
Are there others?
No, he's the last one.
How can you be sure?
I took a good look at his family. From the condition of the shrouds, I'd say the last one died 50, 100 years ago.
How old does that make him?
Oh, I wouldn't even guess.
Thank you. Roxy. Roxy.
Oh, it's you, Dad.
Go see if the rock's in place. He's gone. Now's our chance.
It's there. What are we going to do? What can I do?
Help me back. I gotta sit down. No, no. Don't touch it.
It's got to be tied up with something, doesn't it?
There's some aspirin in my ear bag.
I don't see it.
He brought it here. It must be around someplace. Keep looking. You probably hid it somewhere.
Oh, here it is.
The aspirin's in that small pocket. Give me two.
Drink a lot of water. It'll give you strength.
It won't knit bones, honey.
It's got to be tied up with something, doesn't it?
Oh, it feels pretty good now.
Liar.
That's no way to talk to your father.
The trouble with you is it spoiled you.
You sure did.
What can I do?
Nothing. I'll just sit here.
How about if I washed your face? Or gave you a shave? It'll make you feel better. You've got all your junk here.
Okay. I'll get his attention. You run
and
out.
Leave you?
Do as I tell you.
Not this time, Dad.
You were lucky last night. He's had time to think about you.
I'm not going to leave you to get your head bashed in. My father didn't raise me that way.
Something else. Make a production out of it. Say, hum, whistle. Come on. Bring him, keep busy. Here he comes.
Well, that that doesn't say much for my sex appeal. Now I suppose he wants a shave.
Good, give it to him.
Anything to please the customer.
Try these. Watch him with that shaving bone. A better job of shaving him, Roxy.
Hey.
There's no way of telling how old that fellow
Look.
Is.
Don't get the idea I don't like you, but my father...
outside.
No, save yourself.
I'll keep him so busy he'll forget the rock.
Once you're outside, run.
Come on. Outside.
She-chaw. She-chaw.
Everything's all right.
Dad!
He's okay. He's waiting for us.
Thank you.
okay, kid?
Dad!
Run, kids, run!
Are you okay?
Honey?
Just fine, Dad.
Wow, wait, there he is. So long, High Pockets.
Thank you.
Melody, look here.
Now, baby, I just had one. That's all. Just one, baby. That's all. I've just had one.
One bottle?
Hey, baby.
You've had enough.
Well, I'll tell you when I've had enough. You do me a great injustice. I've had enough.
Roxy!
I'm ready, Dad.
Well, I'm not. You're going to have to help me. I can't manage the tie.
Here, I'll do it. Does it have to be this one?
Young lady, that happens to be one of my favorite ties.
But the color.
You gave it to me 4 years ago.
Oh. Why, it's lovely. Are you sure you're feeling well enough to go out tonight?
Honey, we've got to go out.
Well, it's not anything special. It's just a party.
Your whole gang will be there.
Yeah.
You can't avoid them forever.
No.
Some of them laugh a little.
Well, if I know Agnes Henderson, she'll laugh a lot. What'll happen to him?
I don't know, but I'm certain we're doing the right thing. If we were to reveal that a giant actually exists, there'd be a whole army out there tracking him down like an animal.
No, they wouldn't. We wouldn't let them.
Honey, he's from another age, another eon. Come in.
Hello, Mr. Miller.
Hello, Tom.
Wow, Dee, wow, wow.
You sure look swell, Roxy.
Thank you. I'll only be a minute.
Is something wrong, Mr. Miller?
We're just talking about our little adventure.
Oh, I see.
You do?
Well, sure. A girl like Roxy don't get over a thing like that right away.
Doesn't.
That's what I say. She's got to get her mind off it. And this hop tonight will help.
Hop?
Yeah, my combo's going to be there. Man, they swing.
So I understand.
I'm ready.
Well, let's split then. Mr. Miller, I got my dad's wheels tonight.
Really? Do they fit on your car?
You're funny, Mr. Miller. Real funny.
Grr.
Yeah.
Hey, wait a minute, friend. What is this, a masquerade?
That is Miller's giant, darling.
Oh, come on, you can talk plainer than that. Look out, Mr. Cushman, he's for real. What did he say?
He's real.
Of course, he's real. Jerry, quick, call the police. There's some kind of giant here.
block. Large man or giant creating disturbance. Proceed with extreme caution.
At the old rock house on the Brownsville Road, the crazy things happen according to the code. You turn to the left at the sign of the toe to the empty old house on the Brownsville Road. The old rock house on the Brownsville Road. A crazy things happen according to the code. The code of the ghosts at the sign of the toe. Nobody lives on the Brownsville. Oh, they scream in this way and they bring in the day and the wind sound make you shiver. They dance and they sing through the wildwood ring and the noise goes down to the river.
I don't blame you in the least.
Oh, it's you, Dad.
I agree with you 100%, but perhaps we should be a little more discreet about it.
What on earth are you talking about?
Getting as far away as possible from that music. It's a good idea, but we guess here.
No, the music's wonderful. I could listen to Tom sing by the hour.
And you have.
I just wanted some fresh air, that's all.
Is it, honey?
No. Dad, I've got the funniest feeling.
What is it?
I can't describe it, but I just know something's happened to him.
Him?
Eegah. The giant. Or whatever he is. Something's happened to him.
Roxy, look at me. I love you very much. You're more like your mother every day. Every living thing was her personal concern, and she worried about them.
That's just it, Dad. But you see, worry isn't the feeling that I have. I don't know what it is. He's a creature. Well, you just have to look at him to see that. He even tried to kill us. But yet...
You can't get him out of your mind. Then it'll be up to somebody else. Maybe him, huh?
Hey! Where you been? I was belting out a tune just for you in there. I look up and you're gone.
We can hear every word, Tom. I said hear, not understand.
You're funny, Mr. Miller. Really funny. Come on, Roxy, let's dance.
Wait a minute.
What's the matter?
I thought I heard sirens.
That's Dino's sax. It leaks.
Roxy!
No, no, mister. Don't. There he is. Hold! Hold! Or fire!
poor devil.
Remember, I love you.
Where did he come from?
Is he real?
Who is he?
Yes, he was real. It says so in the book of Genesis. There were giants in the earth in those days.